What's up, guys? Today I want to unbox the Yipo 737S. And the reason why I bought this laptop was because it's a replica of the Apple MacBook, the 13 inches. Apple MacBook 13 inches, 0.3. It's a complete everything from the design to how it all look. You know, this is an Intel laptop. It's running Intel power processor, but it's the basic mobile Intel processor, the one you find on the tablet. Though Microsoft used one of the Intel processors in this category for their Surface Pro, I think the Surface Pro 3, yeah, the student edition, the cheapest one. So it's not just about the processor now. We've seen even Lenovo does have some of this brand, and Asus does have some of this Intel brand mobile processor, but you will not find them as cheap or as affordable as this because they are big brands. On this side is just where you have the specifications. You can see that the specification is a 128. This is the 128 gig version, you know, of the laptop. The 4 gig RAM and then 4-core CPU clocking at 1.4 gigahertz. Is the Sherry tray. So what I'm gonna be doing now, I'm just gonna be opening the box. Let's see how the laptop does look like, you know. Mind you, there's a lot of things I'm gonna be talking about this laptop, so let's just see what it does look like from the box, you know. I don't know how the packaging so I was hoping to open it from the bottom part. So let's put it back. Turn the other side down. Okay, so that's what it looks like. Take this away. You see, that's the charger. So when I've touched this, you can see how it came. Oh, let's see. I'll be happy if the menu does come in English. I think it does. Oh, that's cool. You can see everything is in English language. This, I wouldn't call this a menu. It's just like an introduction to Microsoft Windows 10. You can see from the screen, if the camera can pick it. See, it's just an introduction, not particularly for the laptop. Now, if you're new to Windows 10, maybe this might help you, you know. So that's that. Let's put it away. So let's bring out the laptop itself. Whoa, there's a plastic here on the front, so that's why it's shining, because I don't think if you remove the plastic, it's not gonna shine, you know. Let's see, so I'm saying I don't like the feel though, so I like it. I do like the feel a lot. The bottom, that's it. It's nothing. How come this is thin? You know, the material. We find a lot of this material on the Chinese product, or product from China, maybe from the Chinese OEM. I don't think is a quality aluminium, to be fair with you. I think it's plastic polished. Yeah, I think so. At the top, I think it's using the same thing. And though it does look like a silver aluminium, I don't think so. Another thing is it's gonna rub off. You know, it's gonna rub off on the long run. You know, maybe it's not gonna be a short while. Maybe after a few years, or where your palm is really working, then it's gonna really rub off. So I'm gonna put the box away. Let's focus on the laptop itself, because the only thing I'm expecting from this laptop is surprise. Is a 170 laptop, because this is the 128 gig version. So I'm not really expecting some miracles, you know, I'm not expecting loads of miracle from the laptop. On the side here, this is where you have your memory, you know, expandable slot, the USB, and the this one is the mini HDMI converter, you know, where you want to convert to your TV or something like that. On the other side, I guess this is the microphone. Yeah, that's the microphone. I'm gonna test that out. That's the 3.5 audio jack. Another USB and the power. I might test the microphone out during my video. So when you hop on the laptop, what does it look like? Whoa, I'm impressed. This is complete. I just like the design. Sleek and beautiful design. You know, I just like the design. And on the top here, you have the webcam. I'm gonna test the camera too. I'm gonna see. You can't really get much from 2 megapixel camera. Hello, you can't really get much. So don't expect miracle, like I said. The only thing I just wanna see is the performance. I've used a tablet of the same processor, the same 4 gig RAM, and I know how it does perform on Windows. So the only thing I want to see is the performance. I'm not expecting too much, but at least my first impression about the design is exactly what I saw on the website when I was ordering the laptop. It's beautiful, it's sleek. I just like it, you know. Just like it. Oh, let me even compare with the Surface Pro 4. Here's the Surface Pro 4. Let's see. You can see the Surface Pro 4, how small it is compared to this. Oh, you did not have the same screen size. No, the Surface Pro 4 is 12.2 inches screen. Why this is 13.2? I suppose there's a lot of bezels around the screen, you know, around the YIPO. You know, there's a lot of bezels that could have been trimmed down, but the reason is best known to them, you know. You see, there's a lot of bezels, and that's the same kind of bezel you find on this Apple, you know. Not as thick as this, but you still find plenty of bezels around the Apple Mac. So you can see, so for me there's no comparison. I mean, if you look at the Surface Pro 4, let's open the screen, you see still got some bezels here. I don't know if the camera can pick it, the difference, you know, from here, that's where the bezel is. But anyway, we're not talking about the Surface Pro 4 anyway. So that's the LED light, like I mentioned earlier. It does light up. I'm gonna test that too, you know. It does light up, like, you know, like the Apple Mac logo on the back, you know, it does light up. So let's put the laptop on. I just like my first impression about the design is it's okay, it's clean, it's sleek, and it's beautiful. I like that one. I'm gonna put the laptop on now, see how it's gonna perform. You know, that's my main priority now. There's a power button. I suppose you have to press a node. Guessing, yeah, you do have to press and load the power button. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna try and focus on the screen size now, so you can see everything clearly. Another thing I want to mention, I don't know how that's gonna work, because I saw it that you get Google Unlimited Drive, you know, Google Drive Unlimited storage if you buy this laptop, and I don't know. There's nothing in the box. I don't think there'll be any. I've not seen anything so far. So the laptop is booted up now. And mind you, I've paused the video to put my account on the laptop. So I've put my account, I've put the Wi-Fi, and then during that process, there's a lot of update going on in the background. So I let the laptop update. So the laptop is updated now, and I installed some application. When I first bought the laptop, I checked the storage here. I was left with 105 gig, but now after updating and installing just one application, I still got 95 gig. I don't know if you can see, 95 gig storage left, you know. Move this away. Yeah, you can see 95.1 gig free storage. So this is the 180 gig version. With this, you're not gonna go wrong with what 95 gig storage if you're still there. To be honest, if you want power, like if you want power, powerful PC, powerful laptop, powerful notebook, this is not for you. If you're a business person, if you're a student, yes, you can get this. And you want a budget laptop that will do the job, you know, and you just want to feel like, okay, you're different from the rest, you know. You're using a Windows stylish laptop, you know. Yeah, you can go for this because at this junction, a lot of things come out of China. And I find them to be, maybe they're not top range quality, but at least there's something. They're better than what we used to see before. So they design everything. They're better. So what I'm going to do, let me see the backlit, how it does light up. Let's see. Whoa, you can see. You can see it does light up like the Apple logo. I might turn up the light so you can see properly on the camera. You know, am I ever going to complete total darkness? You can see. Oh, I need to go to complete total darkness. You see what I'm saying? This is exactly, even in a dark mode, you can still read. You can see the light. Jupiter is still very, very bright in dark. But not very bright when the light is on, you know. So, that's that. So, everything is working as expected. So, let me test the webcam. Let's see how the webcam does look like. The webcam, the camera is here. Let's see what the webcam looks like. Whoa. The webcam, I would say, is not too bad for what you get. Though it does look washed out. I don't know if the camera can really pick it, but you can see it does look over contrast. You know, it's not really, and I don't think there's a setting they can do to reduce the contrast. It looks too bright and contrast on the screen. So, to be honest with you, I don't know. Webcam cameras on these days, on even my Surface Pro 4, I've had it for how many, going to a year now, I've had it. It's all close, very close to a year, maybe in the next year, very close to a year, I've not used the camera. None of the camera, the front camera, the back, I've not used it. Sometimes I even forget it has camera. You see, I'm not saying webcam camera is not good on a device like this, like on a laptop. It's good maybe if you really need it. I mean, if you're Skyping, if you use Skype on this and use a webcam, to be fair with you, you're still going to see that people will still see you, but the quality of the picture will just look funny because you look washed out. That's it. That's just the thing. You will look very washed out, you know. So, yeah, I'm going to be testing the microphone on the Yipo now to see how it does perform. Hey, Cortana, what is the weather for tomorrow?
The forecast for tomorrow shows mostly cloudy skies with a high of 48 and a low of 43.
Hey, Cortana, what is the meaning of Black Friday? Hey, Cortana. What is the meaning of Black Friday?
Black Friday is a noun meaning the day after Thanksgiving, regarded as the first day of the traditional Christmas shopping season, on which retailers offer special reduced prices.
Okay, you can see the microphone is working as expected, perfectly, no error. I tried it, Cortana, and Cortana could hear me and it could interpret what I want, you know. It gave me my answer. The next thing, let me just try the Wi-Fi speed test on this. So let's see how fast the laptop itself is. You know, let's see how fast it is. So far, so good. I'm impressed with the performance. I'm impressed with the design. It's just few bits I need to see what the laptop can do. You know, I'm gonna have to test the speed now. let's see how it does perform, at least. Might have been problem loading the page. I don't know why. It's slow loading the page. Probably because of too many adverts. I don't know. Okay, so it's running the speed test now. Let's see. Whoa. You can see for yourself on the screen. I know there's some reflection, but just bear with me. There's no other way I can do this without this screen reflecting my image in the background. Okay, wow, that's not too bad. I mean, 36.5 megabit per second, and on my Wi-Fi I should be getting up to 80 megabit per second. So you can see it's not too bad. So that is that. I might test, let's see, I don't think it does support gestures, you know. I don't think so. The trackpad, you know, look at it. The pinch and zoom, nothing is working. No. And then you get the clicking sound, like, you know, as you click, the left click, the mouse click. On the front, there's nothing, it's just, you know, it's not functioning. So no gestures, nothing. Oh, it does, but it's slow. I don't know. It just happened now. Two finger swipe. Okay, you can see it's scrolling up and down. Yeah, it does support that. What about pinch and zoom? No. There's nothing here anyway. So you might be concentrating on this if you're using gestures, this part, because there's nothing in the front. So I think the sensor is just around here, the trackpad sensor. To be honest with you, it does support gestures, but it's so slow. It's not very responsive. So with that, I'm not disappointed, because to be fair with you, it's a budget device, so why should you get all these features? You know, it does, but it's so slow. So that's that about the gesture. I'm not gonna waste too much time on that. So now what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be checking the sound quality, you know. I think that's on full volume, you know. That's maximum volume, you see. So full, and the keyboard shortcut work, you know, you press the function key. I might zoom down there. See, you press function key, you know, you want to disable the mouse. It's not working, you know, that's how to lock the mouse, which is very, very good and handy. Maybe you have a child, you know, and it's playing with your computer, you know, to mute it, brightness, to increase the brightness, see. So I think the keyboard shortcut does work, so no error on that, you know. See, you're gonna bring secondary display, things like that, see. So that's it. So what I'm gonna be doing next is, I told you already that I already downloaded a game. I'm not sure if this laptop is going to play game perfectly. You know, let's see the DirectX. Let's see the information about the GPU, and then I have to close this. Let's see. Okay, let's gonna type the DirectX, the X Dang. Let's see the information about the GPU. Oh, it's too small on the screen. I might zoom in a little bit so you guys can see what I'm doing. Yeah, that is it. You can see the information on the screen. You can see the 4-core CPU is 4 GB of RAM, and the paging file is 1.3 meg, you know, 1.3 gig rather. So yeah, it does support direct draw acceleration and 3D acceleration, AGP, everything is enabled. So I don't know about the gaming experience, you know, I don't know how this will cope on gaming, and that I'm sure it's going to be sharing some system memory. You know, I'm pretty sure it's going to be sharing a lot of system memory, maybe at least 2 gig. Let's find out how many system memory is sharing. And you know, you can reduce that one in BIOS. It's up to you. If you want a faster GPU, you know, you can leave it. But if you don't fancy gaming, you can always reduce the system memory, shared memory in BIOS. You know, shared memory helps GPU. It uses a part of a memory to support the graphics controller on your PC. Yeah, I told you. Yeah, it's sharing 2 gig. 2 gig of your system memory is being shared. Can you see that? Yeah, that's it. You can see system memory shared is 2 gig, and it's got dedicated memory of 128. You know, if you want to do the system memory, just let me know. If you have this kind of laptop, I can show you. You know, you have to go into the BIOS. I don't know what key you're gonna press, but I can always find out. You know. So that's that. So now I'm just gonna be running the game. Let's see how it does perform. It's just one game. It's not a gaming test. It's just at least to see how gaming would be on this kind of device. You know. So that's just it. This is not a gaming test. That's the gaming experience. Now I'm going to be trying. Sorry. It's not smooth. To be honest with you, it's not really smooth. So, I already told you earlier that this is not. A gaming laptop. So. You know, I already told you earlier that this is not a gaming laptop. You can see for yourself on the screen and you can judge. So, if you want power, sorry, this is not for you. You know. But if you're a student and if you want power, sorry, this is not for you. But if you're a student or a business person and you just want something within your budget range, something that, okay, you just want to type letter, send emails, yeah, you can get this. You know, this is the kind of thing you can get if you're looking for budget price and you want something very lightweight, you know, It's a very lightweight computer. No, very sleek design. So I think, yeah, that's it. You can get it. But if you want power, sorry, I would not advise you to get this kind of thing, because it's affordable, it's cheap, and I think, in my opinion, it does justify the price. That's fact. It justifies the price. That's it. It does justify the price, in my own opinion. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching my video. Thanks for your time. I will be seeing you next in my next video. Have a good day. God bless. Bye.